Be seated. Who gives this woman to be bride to this man?
I do.
Dear friends and family, we gather here today to witness and celebrate an act of deep love, India and Robert, and their devotion, respect, and love for each other, wish to unite in the holy bond of marriage and to dedicate themselves to each other's happiness and well-being as husband and wife. And on behalf of them, I welcome you all. Although this is their day, it's also a tribute to all of you, for knowing you and interacting with you has helped to make India and Rob who they needed to be to find each other. They'd also like to thank you for that. All of you are the threads of which are woven the tapestry of their lives. Each one of you is an important story that it tells It's the fabric that they wrap around themselves and take comfort in when the world seems cold. And on days like today, when everything is right in their world, that tapestry is proudly spread out and displayed for everyone to see. With all the glorious colors and textures that your diversity adds, y'all hold a place in their hearts reserved for those that they have chosen to call family and friends, and they are deeply grateful for each and one, every one of you here today. My friends, marriage is a supreme sharing, perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of human relationships. It's the joyful uniting of a man and woman whose care and affection and understanding have flowered into a deep and abiding love. Those who take marriage's sacred vows have their lives blended together into one, just like the waters of two rivers come together and are joined to form an even greater one. A true spiritual marriage is an act of metamorphosis, a profound mystery of creation and rebirth. As two become one, it is not a giving up self of or loss of oneself, but rather a giving over to oneself to something greater, a transformation of the self in which we say, I am no longer I, but also we. It's a process in which each can be challenged to discover new possibilities in themselves and each other. In such a marriage, the wedding ceremony is the gateway to this mystery. You have now created something wholly new and transcendent, and something which has never existed before, your marriage. This is an expression that's public and private, precious, sacred, and truly unique to the two of you. In this act, you open yourselves to a fuller experience, an expression of the vast miracle of love. Now, no ceremony can create your marriage. Only you can do that through love and patience and dedication, perseverance, talking, listening, and trying to understand each other, through learning to forgive, learning to respect and appreciate your differences, and learning to make the important things matter and to let go of the rest. What this ceremony can do is to witness and affirm the choice you've made to begin a new life today as husband and wife. At this time, the bride and groom would like to share with one another their personal vows.
Looking back at the time that we've known each other, even from the first day that we met, you've always been looking out for me, and I truly appreciate that. Driving long roads, rain-covered windshields, really early morning crew calls. They were made better because you were there and because you bring coffee. I've always known that I love you. I always have. You've always been my most amazing friend. You've been there whenever I needed somebody, and I truly appreciate that. But one day in January, you came back from a long road trip. And I knew that every road trip you came home from, I wanted you to come home to me. And that's when I knew forever that I would love you and that we belong together always. Before I met you, it was hard for me to rely on people, but because you're so dependable, you've made that part of my life easy now. I promise that no matter how busy and crazy work and life gets, I will slow down and make time for hugs and kisses and for our family. I promise to always be grateful for everything that you do and to never expect you to read my mind and to always make you proud that you chose me as your wife.
First time I met you, I knew I couldn't live without you. Many moments since then as well family, it's friends, it's all the different versions of ourselves that we can lead into other people and to us. I just knew.
Join me in a blessing and a prayer. Lord, help us to remember when we first met and the strong love that grew between us. We ask that our words will always be kind and loving and always be ready to forgive. We put our marriage into your heavenly hand. In God's name we pray. Amen. Indy and Robert also want to acknowledge your parents on this occasion, Laverne and Garnett and Wayne and Pamela. Indy and Robert offer their profound gratitude to their parents for all the love and care that they showed in raising them. The unconditional gifts of love and support that you've continually offered throughout their lives have inspired them to become who they are today, and they thank you from the bottom of their hearts for guiding them to this celebration. Without you, this day would not be possible. So I'd like to begin with vows for you, India. Do you, India Belmore, take this man, Robert Edward Silver, to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love him, honor him, nurture, support him in times of joy and times of difficulty? Do you promise to remain by his side, regardless of what trouble befalls you, and in the presence of temptation, to forever forsake this love? Do you promise to remain steadfast and true? And do you promise with all your heart and soul to honor this vow till death do you part?
I do.
Do you? All right.
Don't put your hand over your mic.
Okay. Says the A1.
To you, Robert Edward Silver, take this woman, India Bell Moore, to be your lawfully wedded wife, to love her, honor her, nurture and support her in times of joy and in times of difficulty. Do you promise to remain by her side regardless of what trouble befalls you, and in the presence of temptation to never forsake this love? Do you promise to remain steadfast and true, and do you promise with all your heart and soul to honor this vow till death do you part?
I do.
The next step, Andy and Rob, is to honor these vows with the giving and receiving of rings by which you symbolize and bind your love. The circle's long been a symbol of the spirit and the power of God. The sky and the earth around, the wind in its greatest power whirls, the sun and moon both round come forth and go down again in the circle. Even the seasons form a great circle in their changing and always come back again to where they were. Without beginning or end, and with no point of weakness, the circle is a reminder of the eternal quality of God and of unending strength. Let the seamless circles of these rings become the symbol of your endless love and unending faithfulness. So as we exchange these rings, Rob, would you please repeat after me? India, I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love.
As it encircles your finger.
As it encircles your finger.
May it remind you.
May it remind you.
Always that you are surrounded.
Always that you are surrounded.
By my enduring love.
By my enduring love.
And India, please repeat after me. Rob. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As an eternal symbol.
As an eternal symbol.
Of my love and commitment to you.
Of my love and commitment to you.
Lord, bless this ring, that he who wears it and she who wears it may abide in your peace and in your favor until life's end. Amen. So let me encourage both of you to give to one another new experiences of joy, to challenge one another so that you may grow. May the love you hold for each other, now sealed in marriage, continue to mature with passing of years. May you never take each other for granted, but always experience the wonder of your union. Be slow to anger, quick to forgive, leaving no tracks of resentment behind each day. May your love consist not only in gazing into each other's eyes, but in looking outward in the same direction. May your life together be a source of strength and inspiration to yourselves, your families, your friends, and to all those whose lives you will touch. Now at this time, we will sign the marriage certificate. So I invite the two of you to come up here. Rob, you on the far side.
The far side.
Okay. For as much as Indy and Rob have openly declared their wish to be united in marriage, and in the presence of God and these witnesses have pledged this love to each other and have confirmed the same by exchanging rings and declaring your vows, I, as a minister and legally authorized to do so, pronounce that you're now husband and wife, and you may now kiss the bride. Would everyone please stand, and I pronounce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Silver.